Kim Dowhill. Welcome back to my channel. Today's just going to be a chilled out, sitting down, talking video because I have a big announcement for you guys. So, without further ado, I am going to introduce you to our new family member. This is Hina. Welcome to the family, Hina. She is a Shiba Inu and we just got her about 10 days ago. I'm not going to go into full detail on how we got her, but if you guys are interested, I can make a video about that on my vlog channel sometimes. Oh, you are a bit bitey today. So of course, she has her own Instagram account, so if you guys want to see her growing up, please follow her on there. And because I don't want to spam you guys with Shiba Inu videos, I made a YouTube channel just for her, so if you guys want to subscribe to that, she would really appreciate it, won't you? Yeah. So Eric and I have wanted a Shiba Inu for a very long time now, for about 7 years. And we finally thought now is a good time to get one. She's, she's a bit crazy. She's a very good girl, but she does have the Shiba scream. Screams whenever she doesn't get her way or if you do something that she doesn't like. So for example, if you put a leash on her and tug a little bit, she screams. She does not like her movements being restricted, so if a door is closed and she wants to go into that room, she'll scream. But yeah, she just has a lot of personality, which I love her so much. I've only had her for like 10 days, but I'm in love. What are you doing? You trying to bite my hair? Okay, I'm just gonna put you on my lap for now. So Eric and I are super excited to raise Hina as part of our family. And yeah, I've just been so happy. Like over the last couple of weeks, I've been cleaning up so much pee and poo, but that is okay. I signed up for this. So yeah, it's okay, honey. Yes, yes, little girl. You like hair. Oh, you like my hair. Okay. Okay, I'm just going to put you outside so you can play for a bit and then you can come back later into the video, okay? So the reason Eric and I decided to get a Shiba Inu, well, we've been wanting to get a dog for about 7 years now. So Eric knows that I absolutely love dogs. I've always grown up with dogs. So he knew from the very start when we were dating that if you were to date me, you also have to love dogs. So we wanted originally to get a husky, but then we realized that they're a bit too big and maybe a bit too much to handle. And then we decided, how about let's get an Akita? But then we quickly realized that yeah, they are just as big as huskies and hard to handle. So then we thought, oh, maybe a Shiba Inu because it's like half the size of an Akita. And yeah, we just really, really love how they are because we've actually spent a lot of time with Shiba Inus. And okay, I'm just gonna say this now that if you are to get your own Shiba Inu, please do your research beforehand because they are a lot to handle. I've had dogs in the past and they were a lot easier to handle compared to Hina. But besides that, she's just amazing and we love her so much. So a Shiba Inu is actually really difficult to get in Australia because there's only about 20 registered breeders. So I decided to apply for a Shiba Inu last year after our wedding. So Eric and I got married in January 2020 last year, which I am still in shock at how lucky we were to be able to have a full normal wedding. Like all of our friends were telling us that our wedding was the last time they ever traveled. I just feel so lucky and so grateful that we were able to do all of that. So after the wedding, pretty much COVID hit and lockdown happened. And yeah, I knew from that point that unfortunately, we weren't going to be able to travel anytime soon. To be honest, I thought that we would be able to travel maybe end of 2020. But by the looks of things, I don't think that we would be able to go anywhere until probably like 2023, to be honest. So yeah, I applied for a Shiba Inu because, well, I wasn't gonna be traveling anywhere. And the main reason why I didn't want to apply for Shiba Inu before was because I was literally going to Japan like every single month for work. So I didn't want to get a puppy when I knew I was going to be traveling a lot. So that is why I waited until we settled down. So I thought after we got married, that was like the perfect time. So I applied last year and without going into too much detail because it's a long story, I applied with one breeder and that didn't really go through properly. And then I contacted another one just very recently and I was able to jump the queue. So I just feel so grateful because I know the queue for Shiba Inus, there's like 1,000 people for like every single breeder for their wait list. So I was able to skip the queue and I got told that I was going to get a Shiba Inu in like a few days. So Hina was actually supposed to go to someone else. The person who was supposed to take her, they met her and said she was too timid and didn't want her anymore, which I'm actually really surprised about because she's not timid at all. So when the person did not want her, the breeder contacted me and asked if I was interested, and I was like, of course I am, because our first preference was actually a black and tan female Shiba Inu. So the reason why I wanted a female pup was because, well, I'm used to females. I've had Misty and Yuki. Yuki's actually my family dog. She's not my dog. That is why she's not with me. She lives with my family and they love her. She's very, very spoilt. But yeah, I've never actually had a dog of my own. So Hina is my first dog. So when I got that email from the breeder, I immediately booked tickets to go back to Perth. So yeah, because we booked a ticket very last minute, yeah, it cost quite a bit. But at the same time, I was like, look, I kind of want to go back to Perth anyway to see my family and friends. So we went back to Perth for about 10 days. We picked up Hina, and oh, when she first met us, she was insane. She was so crazy. We took her back to my parents and we stayed there for about a week. So Hina got some time to play with Yuki, and yeah, at the start Yuki was kind of like standoffish, but then after the second day they just could not stop playing with each other, which was great. Yuki was amazing. She would teach Hina where to pee and poo, so she learned all of that super quickly. Whilst I was also in Perth, I also let Hina meet a bunch of my friends' pets, so she was able to get some early socialization in. After about 10 days, Eric and I flew back to Sydney and Hina was on the same flight as us. When she got back here, I felt like she was a bit confused because this was a whole new environment. So she was, of course, like marking everywhere, but she's a lot better now. She's been here for about 5-6 days now and she's been getting better every day. We've been training her and we've also signed her up to puppy school. She's also meeting my friend's Shiba Inu in a few days, so that's going to be very exciting. Yeah, so I'm just really, really excited to start this new chapter and have a new member of the family with us. So you guys might be wondering what's going to be happening with all of my travels and stuff. So obviously, because of what's going on, I don't think that's going to be happening anytime soon. Because Australia is very slow with vaccinations, I don't expect to get a vaccine until next year, to be honest. So I don't think that we would be able to travel until at least 2023, which, yeah, it sucks. But at the same time, it's okay. I've learned to deal with it. Like last year, to be honest, I wasn't taking it very well, and that's why I wasn't uploading that much on my main channel, because, well, I planned all these Japan travel videos. I filmed everything. Couldn't upload them because, well, no one's traveling and I don't want to encourage traveling. Well, you can't even travel to Japan anyway. So yeah, I just felt like there was no point uploading any of those videos. So I had to change everything, all my content on this channel, which, yeah, to be honest, I didn't take very well. But at the moment, I feel like I'm in a really good place and I'm just really excited to start this new chapter with Hina. So yeah, I feel like this year I'm gonna try and upload more lifestyle content. So if you guys have any videos you would like me to make, please let me know in a comment box down below. But yeah, with the traveling stuff, I will still eventually upload them whenever we can travel. So like maybe if I have some time, I might go through my old Japan footage and see what other videos I can make, because I know a lot of you guys miss the travel stuff, which, I mean, I also miss it. So yeah, we'll see. Maybe I can upload snippets of those videos for you guys. Since we most likely can't travel for the next couple of years, I thought that it would be, you know, a good time to finally get a dog, because I've always wanted one for the longest time. And okay, like when the borders finally open again and we can travel, I don't plan to go to Japan often anymore because I really want to settle down now. Just before I end this video, I just want to say thank you to everyone who's been supporting me for so long. And yeah, I know that last year I haven't been uploading as many videos as I usually would, but yeah, I feel like this year it's going to change, right? It will change, yeah, for sure, Hina. Yeah, you're sleepy. You're a sleepy girl. Oh, she's a bit sleepy. So yeah, once again, guys, if you want to follow Hina's journey, please follow her on Instagram and also on YouTube. So and if you guys haven't yet, follow me on my vlog channel, which I will link down below, because I will be uploading some vlogs when I picked up Hina. And also I have a gaming channel where I upload Genshin Impact videos. And also follow me on my own social media, which I will link down below as well. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys. You gonna say bye? Bye guys.